Episode 34, Freezy Balls from
Freezy Balls. And with that lovely intro, welcome to the 6-Inch Show, episode 34, as we've titled it, Freezy Balls. We'll explain another time. Thanks for watching episode 33, and if you're brand new to the show, the 6-Inch Show is all about 6-Inch, primarily Star Wars The Black Series and Hasbro Marvel Legends, as well as some other bits and pieces in there. We also look at a lot of very cool toy photographers out there, which Matt curates and pulls together as a co-host here. Hello, Matt. I never even introduced you.
I'm here. It's all good. Yeah. It's very hot.
We're both very hot in lots of ways. Yes, it's very temperature hot in here for us. We're going to go through and look at all the stuff that's new and recent, some deals, some new images for both Star Wars and for Marvel. And again, tons and tons of very, very cool toy photography, which you definitely want to hang around for, so stick on for that. First of all, let's dive in and look at episode 33 comments, the last episode. And we still seem to be having a lot of people kind of having, well, not a lot of people, one or two people having conversations about SH Figure Arts, which just seems to be stirring the pot and not going away.
Look, it's a lot friendlier.
It's a lot friendlier. It's a lot nicer. Because everyone's entitled to their own opinion. So as long as we don't all start swearing at each other, then I don't think either of us mind. Go ahead and have a conversation. But look, this is an interesting point of view. I think, as BikerScout74 said there, he believes SHF are better value for money than Hot Toys, which... Well, at the price of them nowadays with nearly $400, I think he's right. but Hot Toys might hold their money more. I don't know. But a lot of people gave us the top 10 legends. Matt and I went through on episode 33 our top 10 Star Wars Black Series and top 10 Marvel Legends, which was a fun show. But it took us a long time, didn't it? It was like 2 hours or something.
It was. So,
I don't think we realized it was quite as long as that, but it was good fun. And really interesting to see everybody's comments on their top 10. No Rio Durant in top 10s. Good point. I mean, there was a lot of honorable mentions. We talked about the Bantha, that amazing Bantha you shared off a couple of weeks ago. The R2 Hulkbuster you'd shared or we'd seen before. No Sauron in top 5 is criminal. Okay. What? I don't get. Did you get that one?
Nah.
Sauron? What? Oh, I know what he means.
Just Sauron. The pterodactyl.
Pterodactyl dude from Marvel is, yeah. Yeah, just the pterodactyl thing doesn't do it for me, but yeah, I suppose. Elektra. We're really fussy collectors as people out there. My only problem with Elektra is a loincloth thing is too straight. Hey-ho. I know what he means, though. He's I wish it was more windswept. Maybe not. But I know what you're saying. It's a really interesting comment. So there's a lot of stuff on there. And again, we went back to with Vinishtput70 went back and forth again with more of SH Figure Arts. And oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I won't go into that. It's great fun reading the comments. So if you ever had a chance, check them out at the episode 33 mark. Anyway, that was episode 33. This is 34. And we are going to talk about a few things, Star Wars and Marvel. Before we dive into them, Steve Evans is leaving as design director of Hasbro, staying with Hasbro. But Matt, you've got a better handle on this than me. We were talking about this before with a very interesting point about figures still in the works. So Steve will be around for a little while.
Yeah, look, I think it's been established, and we've talked about it before, the turnaround of a figure from concept to release and all that stuff is 12 to 18 months. So if Steve's pulled up stumps, what, 2 weeks ago? We're now, it's Wednesday night that we're shooting this whenever it gets posted in a couple of days' time. But we're, for Australia, exactly a year from episode 9, which means that we're kind of talking about figures he would have been working on between now would be episode 9 figures going up to probably the second wave of 2020. And whoever comes in will step in and refine and do whatever gets done, but these are the figures he'd be working on or would have been working on in the last couple of months would be episode 9 figures and whatever the wave after that kind of January wave, whatever's being announced at, I don't know, New York Toy Fair kind of thing, 2020. So
yep.
We've still got a bit of Steve love to come, even if he's not there. It's
the love of the Steve.
Yeah. So, you know, he's off to other adventures within Hasbro. But I think, you know, somebody who made a huge difference to this wave and really engaged with the community, and not only within my page or the Facebook groups, people's personal pages, photos. Every day he would get up and look through his feed, see what's getting done, talk about it in panels. He would see the comments, react to the good comments, the bad comments, always willing to hear everyone's opinion, good or bad. For him, yep. It was all equal. And, you know, it was through those comments and things, I think, that we got a lot of figure selections. I think we got something like the photo reel face tech without a price increase. Got the more expensive, I don't know what they call them, Star Wars Deluxe, Star Wars XL, Star Wars Gamorrean Guard.
Gamorrean Guard, basically.
You know, the big square box now at $30. So these are all things that have been talked about on the different forums and different places, and these are the things that he would engage with and sometimes get a lot of praise and sometimes cop a lot of shit kind of thing from those who are never happy with anything and those who are happy with everything. But, you know, I'm not as much in the Marvel Legends world outside of this show and a bit of personal collecting and stuff, but I don't see too many of the other toy companies representatives engaging as much and as often. No, this was like almost, if not daily, you're talking about 3 or 4 days a week, there'd be engagement somewhere along the lines with comments or discussions across all different platforms. And I think the figures we've got now and a lot of our show last week, or last episode, 33, when we're talking about our top 10 figures and how good it is at the moment.
Yeah.
That is, I think, a lot about at least Steve's leadership and an incredibly talented team, but I think a lot of it came out through engagement with fans and willing to make changes, acknowledge that things weren't perfect, and then slowly take the time to essentially right everybody's wrongs, with the exception of double-jointed arms and whatever thing people have. But I think if you look at where we were, The Force Awakens, if you take what we just said into context of the 12 to 18 months, mm-hmm. I think he was the person who would have come in on somebody else's first direction on those first couple of waves.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then I would say from probably the ATSI figures or whatever, you started getting either his control throughout, and it's a steady improvement every wave on wave kind of thing. So I think it'll be a big loss, and it just depends on who replaces him and whether they're going to engage with us as a community or just do what they want to do.
I think the only one that I've ever seen in the toy industry who ever engages at the level that Steve has, maybe even a little bit more actually, is Randy at NECA, who's incredibly open, like sometimes too open about information that's really revealing about licensing, and who's a bit of a dick in the industry that won't give the likeness or why or money or that kind of thing. So he gives a lot of information away, but very genuinely good and interesting toy guy. And Steve was the first one, I think, after Randy to be that kind of way, to be open and given information out there. But I almost get the feeling that he was a little bit of a rebel compared to the rest of Hasbro, who are very, very corporate, very must follow the rules. It's Disney brands after all. So there's a lot of control over what's said, when it's released, how it's done, who gets to say so. And I always felt Steve was trying to rebel and push and push and push. And as you said, he really brought a lot of kind of ideas that we all talk about, and he made them happen. So it is a bit of a shame that he's going, but who knows? We've got some great stuff. The 40th anniversary, we did get a lot of repacks, but we got stuff that we wanted. You've really pushed Sixth Sense, that's for sure. Vintage Collection brought it back.
So, yeah. This, the barge.
Yeah.
Aslab. And
the barge, yeah, exactly. Something that's really quite pretty niche these days. It's just not something you're going to see very easily. given the kind of economic changes we've seen up and down in the toy industry, Toys R Us, etc. But yeah, what's this space? And as you said, we've got a long, long time of Steve's legacy to go before it kind of swaps on to someone else. So, very well, Mr. Steve, I think.
Yeah, thank you. And as he did say in one of the comments on one of the posts and stuff, it was a quote from where you're never really gone.
It's true.
He's never really gone.
He's probably going to have some input, I'm sure, along the way. And I'm sure he's kind of rubbed off on his team in terms of the kind of design styles and things and ideas. So I'm sure they'll make it. They'll take it and run with it. We can't really go back, really, I hope. But talking about Hasbro on that subject, there was a lot of confusion over the last couple of weeks. Now, I might have said something that wasn't quite right. I had a little bit of knowledge from somewhere else, and added with something else, and another site posted some information. Long story short, what it boiled down to was Hasbro Toy Shop stating that they were closing some avenues of selling business to consumer. So this only really affects people in the States generally, because there's not many places else. I don't think there's anywhere else around the world. Maybe Canada?
I'm not even sure if Canada can, to be honest.
I think it's just US. Yeah. So there was a couple of avenues that Hasbro Toy Shop would sell to the public. Now, we've got HasCon, which is something slightly different. But when you go to Star Wars Celebration or you go to SDCC, any of these kind of normally read pop organized exhibitions, normally what happens is the people that are there selling the Hasbro stuff from the Hasbro booth is Hasbro Toy Shop. Hasbro Toy Shop is not part of Hasbro. It's actually a separate company operating under the license of Hasbro. So there may be a partnership change happening. There may be something happening. Long story short, anyway, I managed to get some confirmation, and this is really only for Supreme Toy Nerds, but I managed to get some confirmation from Hasbro PR, who gave me this official statement. So to try and simplify it all, our brand websites, Transformers.com, Nerf.com, will no longer sell products directly. So they may be cutting off some other avenues. But the way they worded it was really kind of weird in this other website. And I, again, taking some other inside information that I had about a possible direction, said, well, that's it. HasbroToyShop.com is shutting down. However, not quite yet. They're going to make some changes to the current Hasbro Toy Shop site starting on January the 18th. So we only have a few weeks to go before we find out what that is. Maybe it'll expand. Maybe it will close. Maybe it will change or move to a different partner. I don't know what's going to happen. But there's some more stuff on that. And again, everything we talk about tonight is in the description. Underneath the video on YouTube, every photograph that we share of Matt's stuff that he's curated is underneath there too. All the links to places to buy stuff, all under the YouTube description in the video. So Hasbro Toy Shop might be going, may not be going. I've had experience of using and bought quite a bit of stuff from Hasbro Toy Shop. I don't know if you have ever, Matt, maybe shipped stuff across. They're notorious, and I'm sure you know this as well, for
bad packing.
Opening a box and then going, whee, and letting it fall into the box. They're not really packed. They're not really designed they're not really a toy shop in my point of view. They're just a bunch of people who've fulfilled some stuff.
They don't feel like they're a avenue for collectors. They're an avenue for openers.
No. Yes, for openers for sure. The amount of times we've seen things like exclusives, normally after Star Wars Celebration and San Diego Comic Con, the exclusives are normally available on Hasbro Toy Shop. As we talked about this year, there was quite a few of them still available after the con, which was really kind of bizarre, but good. But a lot of people did get their goods damaged. And that's just, it's just not that kind of place. It's not it seems to be, and I think this is something we've got to remember, and I'll try not to talk too long on it, but Hasbro are primarily Transformers, Nerf, kiddie toy, Chewbacca mask, lightsaber kind of playing company. All the stuff we love, the 6-inch figures, the 3.75-inch figures, are not the big draws for Hasbro in terms of cash. That's not where all the money comes from. So it's a part of those sales, but the big money is on all the cheap stuff to us that you will see the Chewbacca masks and the role play stuff, and because it's pretty simple and it's pretty simple to make. And remember, you've got Hasbro will have board games, Monopoly, and all those other board games under the sun. They also have a big stake or own part of Magic the Gathering, which is just a whole other world of cash. So Star Wars and Marvel, we're this kind of tiny 15%-ish, 20% of all this stuff, but it's very cool stuff. So let's see what happens with Hasbro Toy Shop on January the 19th, but it will be very interesting to see what they do. However, the consistent 20% discounts are a bit of a problem, and a lot of the times they're receiving goods in, and you've pre-ordered them from BBTS, Darkside, wherever you've ordered your product, and then Hasbro Toy Shop shove them up with 20% off sometimes. And that's just not right. So there's definitely been some complaints from distributors and other sites. So who knows what they're going to do, but we will find out. So thank you to Hasbro for clarifying that anyway. We'll find out soon enough. That's enough for the waffle. Let's get on with the show with the Star Wars bit. So we had some new pictures come out in the last 24, 40 hours. This is so surprising. I'm sure you must have seen these. I haven't seen a few posted, though. I'm sure you did. These new glam shots of the archive pics. The amount of people that didn't know this was A, 6-inch, B, they thought it was a brand new release, and C, somebody said, the paint apps are so wildly different. And I'm like, no.
Yeah.
Did you get any confusion? Because people are genuinely a little confused about this.
Yeah, look, I posted them and I was surprised today by the number of people I had to respond to confirming that they were 6-inch. A lot of people were wishing they were 375.
Wow.
Which I thought was interesting. It was a lot of, please tell me this is 375. And I'm like,
no.
Nope, 6-inch. Other people there going, this paint is so much better. I'm like, with the exception of Luke and I guess to some extent IG-88, Bobber and Bosk are the same, and I'm still struggling with Luke until I see the finished product in my hand.
Yeah, me too. It's just at the moment I'm standing with the original was the best. I don't know.
That's what I said today. I think the original and the 40th anniversary, they are better than what I'm seeing. But again, these glam shots are taken 3, 4, 5 months ago, and we know
that's true.
Even what appeared at what was the last con, whatever it was, the London con and the Paris con,
the Italian con and the French con, yeah.
Those international cons in October, November, they pulled it off Stan for not looking right, and they took IG-88 because of his gold look, and the gold look's still there in promo shots.
Yep.
What I don't get is how hard is it to put a figure in last week, take a photo of it, and release the photos this week?
That's a very good question.
We're 4 weeks away from pre-orders, or no, not even that. We're a week and a half, 2 weeks away from pre-orders, and we're probably 4 weeks away from delivery. Or don't quote me on it, but usually they come at the end of January.
Well, it seems like a post
up in California today.
That's right, exactly. Somebody managed to wrangle them out of a Target in California today. They're definitely street dated, and they've definitely got a shutdown date on them, but that seems to be the case. So it's a pre-order for 1st of January anyway, but the kind of middle of the month or end of the month, I think they're due, if not earlier. So we got some glam shots. I mean, what do you think of this package and a look? That's not the same. We've never had a black and red look, so I guess we've never had that image before, the Gregory Titus
artwork. That one does look very 1970s Mark Hamill.
Yeah.
Retro shot, and kind of like the promo shot that was done when he wasn't in character.
Yep.
Like the in-between Empire and, hey, we need Mark Hamill and his orange thing for a bit of a photo shoot. Get him in between New Hope and Empire kind of thing.
And Jason Yakface posted today, I think he changed that image slightly to the holiday special and...
Yeah,
and people actually believed it. They were kind of like, "What's the holiday special?" I'm like, where are people getting this information from? Maybe I'm wrong. Sometimes you just assume people know these things, but I guess I don't know.
The people who are thinking they are new figures and you know, weren't aware of the old ones and stuff proves why the archive line is needed.
Yes, that's a very, very good point. So anyway, you're getting archive figures, people. You're getting re-releases of classic figures, if you didn't know. And there's other ones that have been revealed. Go back and catch up some of the 30-odd other shows. We talk about it there. But that was cool to see them. It was nice to see more of the glam shots and know that there's more coming. And January is normally a very big month for Hasbro, both on the Marvel Legends and Star Wars side. So don't get too drunk on New Year's Eve. There's a lot of pre-orders going to be going up for Transformers 2. So, yeah, save your money and save your pennies. So, archive picks we got. We talked about California. Somebody had managed to wangle them out. Don't bug your targets. Everybody's going to be out doing that now, and chances are you might not get them because they are street dated, so don't be too disappointed. You and I have seen some major bargains at some stores here for Darth Revan's. We've even had Rex's, Lando's, Rex's for about $8 or $9 US. Brand new Han Solos from the previous wave.
The Tarkin wave.
Tarkin wave. Got tons of Tarkins. So there's been a lot of discounted figures going on, but unsurprisingly, it's pretty global too. Well, it seems to be in the US as well. Not quite seen anything in the UK again. If you're watching from the UK or Germany or one of the European countries, interested to see whether you've seen some discount figures there. Possibly not from my experience, but the US has been seeing some Black Series figures turn up at Five Below, a popular $4.99 and under service over there. So there's been some in there, but they've been kind of like older ones, Snowtroopers, ADAT drivers. That's what I've seen. I don't know if you've seen any more.
Yeah, I've seen that. Maybe some Journey Rays have been popping up, I think.
She's been really popular. I've seen a few as well. Definitely seen a few. Another one to check out is Dorkside Toys. They have had a couple of daily deals over there. They had a Patrol Trooper for $14.99. Did I buy a few more? Maybe. He's a trooper. What's not to love? So, yeah. So there's a few more on that site if you want to check him out and head on to them. In fact, they had a few. Let me just open the right window here. They had a few. I bought a couple of loose figures off them this week. They had a couple of really good loose figures. If you're into, oh, they've got the archive ready to roll up there. I got a few people hot and bothered. Yeah, they've got a couple of cool loose figures like Piet for $14.99. And yeah, if you don't need the packaging, it's a little bit cheaper to ship, especially if you're in the UK or Europe somewhere or even Australia. It's quite a difference. There's the Journey Ray there for $10. Rose, nobody seems to want, sadly, at $8. And a few others there as well. So, yeah, check out the loose stuff if you're not too fussed like me these days about packaging. And stay tuned for the archive, which is coming any day. What else do we have? We had, they had Leia as well, actually. The really good Leia, the Bespin Leia. Not Bespin Leia. Was it Bespin?
Hoth.
Hopefully, thank you, for $14.99 as well. So stay tuned. They've got a few other deals. That's a really good price for a brand new figure with facial scan tech. What else do we have? My and your Hoth Leia set and handset arrived yesterday again from Dorkside Toys. Which is, what do you think? Initial thoughts.
Look, I think it looks great. Hilariously, I took it out of the box tonight for the show to put it behind the Christmas special. It's a Christmas gift to myself.
True.
And my wife looked at it and just went, that is an awful lot of box for two figures.
Did she call it a what a box?
No, awful lot of box.
Awful lot of box. I have to agree. It's mental. It's absolutely nuts. I've got it here kind of half opened. And I will share just for 1 second to show how utterly, utterly ridiculously big this thing is. Two dinky little figures in this. These big flaps. It's always with the flaps. I think it's mad. It's absolutely nuts. So, So anyway, it's a kind of crazy looking thing. But so you've taken the figures out yet? Have you had a look at the?
Not yet. I literally took it out before the show. It arrived yesterday, and again, because the box is so big, I was kind of hiding it because I live in a 2-bedroom unit, and a box like that is very valuable.
I know. I'm keeping the cardboard this time after the Millennium Falcon discussions of the Exogorth set, but I'll keep the box and we'll play around with it. But it's just, I don't get the point of the flaps in the front because it's just.
You could have done it with half the size box.
I know. You could have made it really small. Yeah.
The way they did the Millennium Falcon, they didn't need such a big box to give depth of the ramp and stuff.
It's very strange, but it's kind of interesting. I've got a good look at it, so we'll give you some reviews and photos in Matt's site and mine as well. So that's pretty much being delivered. It also went up on Amazon. And let me see. It was more expensive than everywhere else I'd seen on Amazon from memory. It's up at $65 now. So it did not, of course, it's third parties. But I think it was $49 on Darkseid, wasn't it? I can't remember what it was.
$49 or $59, I can't remember.
I can't remember. Oh, well, it's $65 up there. So
I think it might be on BBTS now as well.
Is it?
They might have put it up a good 3 days ago again or 4 days ago.
It seems to be one of these, one of the first specialty retailers sets. So it never really was an exclusive. You and I knew about this set. I did someone else. Was it a year ago? No, 6 months ago or something?
We definitely knew before Comic-Con San Diego.
Yes, and there was a picture of that floating around very quietly in some places. And I was still like, wow, this set is kind of bizarre. I think you and I thought it was going to be. I think everybody thought it was an exclusive, like a San Diego.
They kind of hinted that Hasbro had hinted that something would be revealed on the second or third day of Comic-Con. And you and I, they're going, it has to be the Hoth set.
It has to be the Hoth set.
And then it didn't happen. I was like, because they'd already announced the Exegorth figure, and I think someone gave a fleeting comment about and maybe something else, and announced the Vintage Collection Apra 3-pack, and I don't think something else was announced, but it was hinted that maybe something else. We're going, definitely the Hoth set, definitely the Hoth set. We won't say anything about it, and then it didn't happen. Then it was announced like weeks, if not a month or two later.
Right, was our set.
Oh, when Robot Kingdom put it up, probably in August.
That's right, and they had to pull it down. Yeah. That was nuts. Another bargain that was to be had at one point. There was tons of good bargains for Black Friday and stuff going on, but they were a little bit hard to find at first. But this was a very sweet US $29 for the Dewback. I think now back up to 40. Okay, let's see what it says. Yeah, back up to $40, $50. But what a bargain at $29 that it was. It was like, that's ridiculously good. So
that's didn't buy another one. Second one for.
Did you?
Yeah. What was it? June 30th, just before they cut us off for the 4 months from Amazon US.
Nice.
I was like, yeah, I'll get another one.
I know, the 4 months punishment where we can't buy from Amazon.com. But we're back. Just one little Star Wars custom that I saw, which was really, I mean, some people may not be impressed, but I was. It's a really nice, simple white pauldron on one of the hover tank troopers. I thought it was really nice. That it was really good by Giovanni Nardi.
And
Nardi Sana.
That, if we take the story of George Lucas on Rogue One set word, that whether it's true or not true, is he walked past, saw the different helmets they could be looking at and stopped at that one and was like, oh yeah, that was almost the Stormtrooper helmet. And so they were like, right, that's what we're going to use and we're going to put it in there. So they had the old designs. That's exactly what the Stormtrooper may have looked like in a different world.
There you go. It's kind of interesting. So I just thought that really quick pop off the head, put on a pauldron. Looks kind of good. But if you got some customs, share them. Maybe Matt will post them. That is pretty much it for Star Wars, unless you know of anything else.
Do we want to talk about what we know for 2019?
Yes, good point. Good point. No, no, no. Go for it. You had the load in on that. So go. Yeah.
So I guess what we can talk about now is, you know, that everything we know, i.e. what was revealed this year that hasn't released so far, and maybe what we can speculate. But, you know, as indicated before, the archives are coming in 2019. You can pre-order the first wave, which, as we know, is Luke, X-Wing, Boba Fett, Bosk, IG-88. Mm-hmm. We know the second wave is Anakin Skywalker with two heads, Yoda, the Biker Scout, and whether they hinted at it or didn't hint at it, I can't remember, but there'll be a fourth figure. And
yeah, definitely.
I think the fourth figure is pretty obvious when we look at next year being the 20th anniversary of The Phantom Menace. So,
Jar Jar.
Exactly.
Exactly.
So we've got the archives coming back. We have the deluxe General Grievous, which is a general release, not an exclusive, but we're talking about the, I don't even know if it's deluxe. It might have another name, but
yes, the kind of out of scale that Steve was talking about. It's
the bigger box, the Gamorrean Guard and Moloch. Both of those were exclusives, but General Grievous isn't an exclusive, so that's due out. What else do we know? The standard figures. We've got Ezra and Chopper from Rebels.
Mm-hmm.
We've got Holdo from Last Jedi. We've got the three APRA figures, Dr. APRA, 000, and their
BT.
BT-1.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a Mud Trooper Han Solo and Dryden Voss, Paul Bettany character from Solo still to come. And then we've got three prequel figures being Mace Windu,
Battle Droid,
and Padme from Attack of the Clones.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess, oh, then there's the exclusives. So the exclusives, we've got General Kenobi from the original Clone Wars cartoon.
The GameStop.
He's a Walgreens. He's a Walgreens exclusive. Battlefront Rocket Troopers, the GameStop. Rocket Trooper,
yep.
/ Think Geek, and the most anticipated figure of 2019, Wet Hair Luke Skywalker.
Absolutely.
From Target. And I guess what
hasn't... Oh, that's 3.75. My apologies. Yeah. Sorry.
And then what we've got as well is 20 years of Phantom Menace. And if we take what was said but not said at Comic-Con, at even on the clip that the guys did for us from Comic-Con with Steve and Patrick...
Mm-hmm.
They basically said that'd be crazy not to do vintage cards again. So I take that as the vintage cards will come back in some form. I don't know whether it'll be 10 or 12 or 8 or what it will be, but I don't know. We can speculate, but I think that there'd be a Mace and Padme and Battle Droid repacked as 40th anniversary, or even how did it work last year? I mean, last year they released the Jawa and the Death Star Trooper Commanders, Death Squad Trooper, whatever it was called.
After the release, yeah.
They did it on 40th anniversary in May or March, April, March, May, and then it was in June that it was in the red box.
Mm.
So maybe we'll get a first wave with the Holdo and the Ezras and the Choppers and all that stuff, and then we'll get a 40th wave, and then after the 40th wave we'll get that second wave, which will have the Maces and the Padme's and stuff in red boxes.
That would make sense. Going by the kind of formula that really hit home and worked for them in that previous year with the 40th anniversary, that dual release. I hope it's not the 10 or 11 figures that we got out of 13 or 14.
Yeah.
That was a heavy repack situation, but I guess it's like the Marvel Legends vintage line. It's very similar in that way.
Yeah, and you can choose to do it or...
Yeah, it's true. You don't have to buy them. It's true.
So, yeah, I think that's what we know. I don't think they've announced any vehicles or any beasts or anything. I think you're slightly out of focus from the Han Solo.
Am I? Out of focus? All right.
There you go. Nearly back. No, it's still out, but anyway.
Okay.
Find itself. But yeah, that's what we know so far. There's no vehicles or creatures. There's all those ones we've just listed, but that's what we know. And there's what I'm going to scare everybody. We're probably like 6 weeks from New York Toy Fair.
I know. Isn't that freaky?
So,
no.
It's usually mid-February, isn't it?
That's right. Yep.
So we're less than 2 months. And yeah. I think that's
bitter, bitter cold New York. It is not fun to go to that, but yeah. Gonna be a busy year. I remember the post Toy Shiz made last year. I can't remember what it was, and he calculated up the money for Marvel Legends and Star Wars and all the exclusives, and he did a great job, dude. And it just, I was like, how many thousands? It was really brought it home, the amount of money that yeah, you gotta spend to get, you know, every Marvel Legends figure, every Star Wars Black Series figure. It's a lot of money. Anyway, go be a good year. Let's deal with that. So that's Star Wars, pretty much. In terms of Marvel Legends stuff that's been happening recently, we've had a few goodies. We've had a lot of Captain Marvel figures released. I love the picture of Nick Fury. His face is just complete shock in this glam shot that we got today. Cat and Captain Marvel there in lots of different poses and so forth. Skrulls and all the other terrible figures that are in this wave, frankly. Some people love them, but I think they're pretty rotten. There were some other carded figures. Let me just bring them up. Does this do anything for you at all, Captain Marvel figures? Is it?
Not really.
Not really. I don't know how many people are too excited about this. I think it's, you know, big Marvel movie, so I'm sure it'll help kind of shift some of these. But certainly, Carol Danvers looks pretty good. Really not sure about this one. But the facial scan looks good, and dying to see more about this cat and what's going on. Nick Fury with that same old body again and again that we've had before, as we talked about. Grey Gargoyle, that is going to be a cheap figure very quickly, I would imagine. Time will tell. Janis Vell, Talos, and there's another there's no boxed figure available for the, I think it's the Star Force Commander. So, yeah, we got some new pictures of that. And just before we started the show tonight, I quickly sent it this post. Captain Marvel, Marvel Legends exclusives leaked out. So we've got a Star Force version of Carol Danvers. And I don't even know what that says. It's like a flame on Carol Danvers. I don't know. She's basically got Fantastic Four, Johnny Storm hands, fireballs, and a little bit of flame, and a swap out head, and flaming hair. So, yeah. No idea where they're coming to. I would suspect one will maybe be a Target, one will maybe be either a Walmart or Walgreens, something like that. I'm sure that would be the case. But yeah, that was just something else in terms of Captain Marvel, which does look good. We also got some pictures. It's probably old news now, but in the last time since we did the show, we got some more pictures of the Kingpin wave, which I know you're excited about.
Ordered.
That is quite, yeah, I know, me too, pre-ordered, but that is quite the cool buff. He really is something special. So yeah, a lot of people, I know, a lot of people are going to be after that figure. A lot of other figures in the wave, I don't know.
I don't know. I actually don't think I like any of them.
I like the Spidey. Although, as someone said, there's no ab crunch going on here. Although there was a version of it earlier on that did have one, but yeah. Yeah.
Probably just can't have it.
No. Yeah, I need that Kingpin, though. So, and I do like that Thrasher. I always like the comic of Thrasher. So, eh. And that one's not bad. Silver Sable. So, you know, coming soon. But just another chance to get to see some more pictures from...
That's shipping in January, isn't it?
I think it is, yeah.
Cool.
We also got some other Captain Marvel, I should say, is 15th of January for pre-orders if you want to keep up to date. But we'll follow Matt and I. You'll find out about it. We won't miss that out. Mystique was posted by Hasbro on their account for a Walgreens exclusive available early this year. And it comes with a couple of heads. I can't remember her name. She's an ex, another X-Men character. I can't remember who it is. One half of kind of blending into Rogue or trying to be Rogue, and the other character, the one with the silver head, I can't remember. Someone's going to kill me in the comment. Go, how do you not know who that is? And I'm like, I don't. I just don't. So, and I don't really care either because it does nothing for me. Do you? Any idea who that is?
Nope.
There you go. Two of us didn't know. So I'm sure someone will have a good bitch about that. So we got a carded pick of it too. Come on. There we go. So a little bit better of a close-up there. And gold guns, which we've seen before from Mystique. Not really all that different, Mystique, from the previous one that we had. But again, look for your Walgreens coming soon. If you're lucky enough to have a Walgreens. Some of us aren't. Mystique. Walgreens did have some deals. If you're still maybe got a store that's got it, they did have some $16 Spidey and the Thing and exclusive figures. So yeah, check around if you're looking for that. They also had some Funko Pop deals and other goodies as well. So want to buy one, get one 50% off. But that was on the 9th of December, so it's probably over by now. But never mind, you might be lucky.
Just think of it this way as well. In a sad, sad scalping world, someone in America could buy a $15 thing, could have bought 10 of them and could come over here in Australia and make $1,500.
There you go.
They're selling us, so I had a look up again on what they're costing Aussies, and anywhere from 130 to 150 bucks.
For a thing?
For a thing on eBay's and...
No, it wasn't at that at the beginning.
No, not at the beginning, but right now. So when you're seeing those December 9 sales of $15.99.
Yeah, that's, yeah, that's crazy.
120, 130, I saw 150.
Plus shipping?
Yeah, plus shipping. So that's Australian dollars, so turn that back into US. But
for like 70 US?
It's crazy.
That's bananas.
And everyone else who had it at the 60, 70 bucks, they're all sold out. All the
Oh man, flippers.
Like, I mean, if I wanted to buy the other members of Fantastic Four, we're talking about $56 to $59 for those figures.
This is something I found over years of very bitter experience, just as you've said. If you don't get in quick, and I mean like pay attention to shows like this or your channel or my site, and pay attention and get in there and buy them, the prices go up. Some eventually go down, but yeah, it's a pain in the ass. One that happened around the kind of Black Friday timeline as well, which absolutely surprised me because this thing's brand new, but Amazon's exclusive Sentinel and Wolverine, my goodness, this thing went from, it went all over the place. Went down to the 80 bucks and then eventually dropped down to, I think, at 1.50, 55 or something, which is ridiculously good. At one point, so it was at half price at one point. So it was 99 normally, went down to like 54 or something like that. And oh my God, so many people were like, thanks, I got like five of them. A lot of people bought that at that price. So yeah, it's a good price. Very, very good price. That's pretty much it for Marvel Legends, unless you know of anything else.
No, I'm going to disappear for 1 second and come back.
No worries. Just before Matt comes back, if you haven't followed him before or know what we're talking about here, basically Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries is Matt's page. And what he does on that page is he curates basically the best of all the toy photography that is out there. Online, and every couple of shows or every show, we literally go through some of the best stuff. And here we are. So, Star Wars The Black Series on Instagram is what you want to follow and join the other 103,000 people who are following all this stuff. And we got some goodies. So we talked about Archive, as usual. You've got some, that's a very unusual looking paint scheme in that book, but that's, somebody's done a Return of the Jedi paint on that, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, custom 112 Galaxy. Yeah, yeah. Very cool.
I want it now. I'm ready for the next Boba Fett.
Treadwell. What's going on here? This is awesome.
That's a custom.
That's very cool. Little Treadwell droid. You got a
clean through him, yeah.
Nice. How cool is that? Damn. And I was going into Tashi Station. $40 plus shipping. Very good. Check that out if you want to get your own little Treadwell droid, then that's where to go. That's a very nice broody shot. Looks like Scotland in the back hills there.
Somewhere in the UK.
Somewhere in the UK. You can just tell it's cold and wet. Very good. Good shot by Rogue Studios there. That's very nice indeed. Boba in the Archives, which we talked about. Always a Darth with these chest panels in there. Always lit up. That's a cracking Leia picture. What a great stand. How did he get up to stand? Wow. Pop Senpai is the author of that one. But looking very good indeed. If I could get the camera to... what's going on with my browser? Need to come down in size. My browser seems to have hung. Come on. What's going on with this? Refresh. What other ones do you have on your page? Nice moody Darth there with the red. Ooh, I've not actually seen Darth Revan's helmet back like that. His hood. There you go. I've never actually taken the cloak off far enough to actually see beneath the...
I guess cloak. I had to cut it off, isn't it? Because it's a hard plastic.
Oh, so it is. Is it? No.
That's a custom robe, yeah.
It is. Damn. That's a good point. I never thought about that. That's why. That would be why. Nice couple of biker scouts in the trenches there with new weapons. That looks really good. Star Wars Online is the author of that one. Looking good. Who's this? Oh, it's Jawa.
There's a couple of Jawas. There's three shots in there. I don't get enough love, Jawas.
That's true. Wootini. I'll look to that as well. Darth Revan. More biker scouts. That's a nice trippers. That's a really good shot there.
That's your mate, Jay Bantha Maker.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In his custom made Hoth.
That's very cool. I'll get it.
If you click on his page, I think he posted a behind the scenes shot of the setup. There you go.
Damn. Look at that. That's really good. That is absolutely superb. Really nice pose there in Goldenrod. It just looks really quite the part there, doesn't it? The lighting's superb, though.
He always nails the lighting.
Oh, my God. Very good. What a good job, Mr. Bud Futu. He's got lots of other shots here as well. God, that's really nice. Straight out of the movies. And a little bit of mist as well as the ice field. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. More biker scouts. Good look at them. All the lots and lots of bounty hunters, obviously, as everybody completes their collection. I like this black and white one, though, from Black Series. That's nice. It really does look vintage. Looks like an old war photograph or something.
I'm going with Young Guns.
Young Guns. I like that. Scum and Villainy. I like this one, too. This is the kind of, I guess this is like the robot chicken elevator scene. Is that what this was going for?
I assume so, yeah.
That's nice. That is nice. Yeah, as they went to meet Darth. Lovely. What a really good pick there of recreating the kind of Empire scene. Wow. Some space walls. Good job, Swick Picks. Very, very nice job indeed. And I like your, on your threesome, I can see it. I can see the sunsets there. Very nice. Couple of Mimbans, couple of Sandies, and a very happy Jawa. by Stormtrooper Robbie. That is so cool.
I wonder how he did that.
Interesting. We get some Dengars. Has everybody managed to get the Dengars? Nice little theme going on there too. Is that some custom Snowtrooper? They look a little bit shiny and polished. Buff Trooper. Maybe he's been buffing them up. I don't know. They're very buffed.
Gave them some Vass.
Yeah, probably Vassily. A little repainted Yoda looking. Wow.
A little bit of hair, and it's just incredible. Grey areas Yodas are just insane. And as I say in the poster, I think super happy to get a, you know, revisited Yoda figure from the archive, but man, I want this deluxe Yoda.
That's very nice indeed. Nice color on the cloak too. And we get some nice Forlorn action with these green glowing eyes of the light behind. That's very cool. And Rey with, I don't know, what's this, midichlorians or something? I don't know.
We'll just go with the Force.
Go with the Force. Okay. Go with the Force. This one was for me. It was all for me. Yeah. Thank you for tagging. See, the cat agrees too. Roddy,
that was a horn.
The horn. Oh, well, okay. The horn agreed. Very cool photograph. Roddy, ET1. Very, very nice indeed. And more of your favorite, Darth. That's amazing, even just as a close-up there with, I guess, what is maybe a screen behind them.
It's a screen behind, yeah.
It's just, you know, you can get away with it. Good job, Knight of Ren 789. And a nice little Moody Broody Tripper talk. Red Dog 5.
Just looks like it's got that old 70s Death Star look.
It does, doesn't it? There's something about it, the lighting, the angle. It's very nice. Lots of laser bolts going off there. Nice action pose there by Star Wars Figure Photography. Good old Cody. We don't get enough Cody on pages these days. He's just such a good-looking figure.
I guarantee he has to be in
Archive
Wave 3.
100% Archive. It'd be nuts. It'd be absolutely insane not to re-release that figure. Money on the table. Nice flying Boba there. Lots going on in that picture there from everything Kylo. A little bit of lighting on Darth. That's a nice one as well by Mandalorian _ Photographer. And Trippers. What's going on here with this one? This is
So this was Jason work more or less. He won one of the Star Wars .com fan prizes for this little commercial.
Oh, wow.
A couple of the guys won some prizes. They announced their winners last week. So I think the post just on the other side of that artwork, there was...
There's one here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Trevor won for that picture, and then Jason won for his commercial, and Zay won for his family photo, which I think might be the next shot. Me and his daughter.
That's nice. Very nice indeed. What's going on here? Taking a break. The waiting. Tusken up. I'm yet to see the scarfy bit here, which just feels really weird. Yeah. Or looks really weird. That's a cracker of a Dengar there. Remember seeing that one there with the rain. Everything Kylo again. Very, very nice. $59.99 is what they had them. So $5 cheaper at Dorpside than it was Amazon. Got a Palp skin on there. He's not looking very happy, but very nice red lighting by Root Leaf Stew Squad. Fantastic work indeed. And that's a very nice look as well. What a custom head there, clearly, it's, I think.
An SH Figure Arts head.
That's nice. Repainted one, okay. By me and a repainted Han with white hair, which Steve always said he wanted to redo. Donut time, that's a beauty. I've got that. That's the little set of 1/6 scale little extra bits and pieces with the donuts, yeah. Very cool indeed. Trooperi, that's a really nice one. They're all sitting talking, having donuts. Very cool. God, they're all cool. Every one of them's cool. That's the problem. There's just like every damn one is cool. Very weathered troopers there, and Imperial Grunt. So again, just if you're watching this, Star Wars The Black Series on Instagram is where you want to go and just pick up all of this stuff. I mean, just that, again, that really nice Woody Harrelson figure there, which was one of my top 10 of the year. In fact, it was really quite high up, I think, from memory. This photograph by Alan G. Kenny, I think, shows off just how good it can be. And he did have at that moment, didn't he have that uniform at one point?
Yeah, and on Membin. So I think he's given him the Tarkin breastplate and the Veers, not Tarkin, the Veers breastplate and Veers Imperial hat, and nice. Puts a jacket over it. And
it works really well. Tobias Beckett, great, great figure. The Blind Dude from The Force Unleashed, Ram Kota, there you go. Wow, that's quite a nice job there, but Plastic Surgeon 88. Now we got a three set going on here. Oh, what's this? No, I was going to say archive, but it's not. But
no.
What's your theme?
Portraits. It was just
Dark in the Light, Bucketheads, Master and Apprentice. Okay. Very cool. Oh, what's going on here? It's a custom. Big Tycho. That's nice. What a great facial sculpt.
Yeah.
And that was by Filezzi. that's going nice. Corona 4, sliding doors. Yeah, that's a very good point. That could have been. Another one of my.
And it's incredible. A bit bigger, a bit bulkier. I think it's the legs of Empire Han repainted. Obviously, the head's repainted too, but it's just giving out and a little bit more. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. The colors are beautiful. And they fixed the blaster there as well, which is nice. Yeah, that's quite the job. Same old X is the author behind there. Lovely Boba. And a very cool looking Darth as well there. Choking the life of people. And they're all good. What am I saying? Every single one of them is good. Nice little Piet shot there as well. Lovely blurred troopers in the background while he's in focus. That is nice. Work more or less as usual. Always good. That's nice. We get the real font or the neat close enough to the font. Very cool, Mr. Gizmo. Makes me want to watch the film again for that little sequence. At last we have the mighty Chewbacca. Wow, look at that shot. That is just, again, just lighting pretty much. Okay, of course, there's a really nice background there, but that lighting just nails it. Chip monsters. Very, very cool. Look at those two killer figures. Such good figures.
They're really great. And again, I think last episode we spoke about Beckett made yours, and for me, Val was the honorable mention of what was an outstanding figure, but I just had others I needed in front of her.
Yep. Some Rio Durant, some Dengar, more donuts. I like the Krispy Kreme box. Very cool indeed. We've got some masks on Veers there and others. That's a cracker of a shot. I guess maybe a screen again in the background. God, that looks phenomenal.
Not too different to what they did in Return of the Jedi with Lando and
Han. That's isn't that true? I was just about to say the same goddamn thing in that very sequence, I think, at that point, wasn't it?
No, their one was Return.
Oh, Return of the Jedi. My apologies. There was a couple of dodgy background shots in Empire too, but
Definitely on Bespin.
Yeah, very cool, Blainer.
I love that. Go back up one, the Luke and Darth shot.
Oh, that's nice from the corridor from Bespin. Oh, yeah. EGG232. I like it a lot. I think you tagged me in. You did. Scarif slut here. Captain Roswell again. Lovely shot. A lovely, lovely shot. And that's a really nice one as well by Ray. I remember seeing that, thinking the rain just looked so good. Maul. Yeah, I think Ray steals it.
Yeah, I agree. That's why she went first.
Jedi Journal. Nice. That's not a figure we don't see that often, that Shadow Trooper or the Shadow Biker Scout Trooper. Trippers, 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 trippers. That was a head swap. Did we cover that one the last time? Maybe I'm wrong.
No, but we covered someone else's. It's just a
Yep. Seen a lot of people do that or talk about doing that. That's head swap. But yeah, Slave Leia doesn't bother me all that much, actually. And some very nice Moody Bridgy shots there. B area Sean. Just getting the lighting and really picking up on all the little accents and the sculpt as well as the paint there too. Nice. Just stop if there's anyone that you're particularly... That's a cracker as well. They're all good, but lovely dust storm in the background there. Concrete bricks. Good job.
There's a custom gonk.
This one, yeah. Yeah, so it is. Captain Chaos, looking nice. Wow. What's the theme here with the three oranges?
It was just Toy Bros, I think, review shots, actually, to be honest.
Oh, nice.
But I like the orange backgrounds and always good figure posing.
That's very cool, Mr. Stevie. Yeah, we get some really good stuff with facial scan tech. It's particularly good. Great scene in The Empire Strikes Back there. I like it. It's a trap. A little bit of Jeremy Bullock.
I always forget that that was said before Akbar's one.
All right, very cool. Han and Exegorth. Nice, nice shot of those three figures. The lighting, again, that orange glow from the back. Just playing around the lighting can just make or break a figure. And those three definitely... from BDA showing just again, just belters, really, really good. That's beautiful. What a difference the light makes to the face and the skin tone. And superb. And that takes us back to the last show. Now, Matt has some other stuff. So, we talked about this. This is the Star Wars The Black Series account, Instagram.com/Star Wars The Black Series. But Matt also runs Toy Tribe, Star Wars 13, and some other bits and pieces. But very quickly, some Toy Tribe stuff that he's done. We're predominantly known Star Wars. Was this recent? This is an old photograph, isn't it?
Don't know. Just Sideshow just shared it recently. So. Oh,
okay. Yeah, it seems weird why they cancelled Netflix, considering it was doing well. It just had a great season.
The number four show for the year. It's a Netflix Disney thing. And
I think so.
For the first time today, I saw Disney's exec who heads all their digital, Hulu, will head Disney Plus. You know, big guy, made the first comment for the first time to say it's not impossible for these shows to resurrect themselves on one of their platforms. I think there's probably a non-compete clause for a year or two before they could come back.
Yeah, that would make sense. That would make sense. Love this shot here of the Hulk and Wolverine with the slashing going on, which is really just bits of plastic, I think.
Yeah. And God,
that looks the part.
For anyone who's wondering, it is a Marvel Legends Wolverine, and Photoshop is Scarecrow's butterfly. Joins in the outfit and stuff.
Okay. What we got here? Oh, it's Hot Toys. Hot Toys. Yep, yep. Father and son reunited. I love this. Did see that when someone else is paging. Yep. Will you get a Wookiee for Christmas? Not a comb. Razor. very cool. Love that shot. That is gorgeous. Marvel Legends UK _. Wow. That is quite the shot.
That Popeye is incredible.
Do you have it?
I don't know. But there are so many great photos. Everyone's taken the last week of it. It really is an outstanding figure.
Wow. Popeye the Sailor Man. Not a lot of people watching this will even know who that is.
So...
You talk about that?
Oh, no, so that's obviously a custom outfit. I was going to get my favorite Mythic Legions.
Nice.
This is now in defense of SH Figure Arts Obi-Wan, that next shot. If we go back up. That one.
Wow.
Has to be the best looking shot of that Obi figure to date. And we've discussed it before, and I don't want to start a new discussion about it, about how disappointing I find this figure and how much of a letdown I find it. This is the first time I've seen it where I go, that lighting, that angle, it looks like Alec Guinness, yeah, as opposed to looking like Alan Rickman. but
it's a little high, the hood. It's a little...
As I was about to say, the thing that lets it down is if you're going to go soft goods and you're going to make the hood, geez, make it sit on the head.
I know. That is kind of weird.
But the face there and that lighting, it does it. But then you look at it again at another light, at another angle, it looks like Alan Rickman.
Yes. Nakatomi Plaza. I take you saw Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse?
Not yet. I'm thinking about going tomorrow morning.
Okay. Very impressed personally. I'm sure you've seen tons of great positive reviews.
I haven't seen anything other than praise.
Yep. It's pretty damn good. What's going on with Felix the Cat here? Why are you pushing Funko? Are you into that or?
Oh, look, I don't mind one or two Funkos, and always had a soft spot growing up for Felix. And there's this thing that most people don't know. I know it's debated and contested, but there's enough to suggest that it's true. Felix was created by an Aussie. He's Australian.
Oh, there you go.
There you go. There is between the dude who's the Aussie who lays claim to him and the artist who was engaged to work for him, they both claimed to have created Felix. But I think I was reading that the Aussie who originally claimed it and was kind of uncontested for 20, 30 years after its creation until he died as an alcoholic and everything else. But anyway, it came back to most historians agree it's essentially Felix is Australian because one of the earliest drawings of it referenced mum spelt M-U-M on the drawing as opposed to M-O-M, and the other artist claiming to have created Felix was American. So it's kind of like, well, the earliest appearance of him features Australian spelling.
Wow.
But yeah, he was born in Paddington in Sydney, and anyway.
You know you're Felix the Cat.
Well, it was just something I've always known that he was Australian, and none of my mates knew and all that stuff, and it's his 100 years, and yeah.
So this looks like the USB cable, metallic cable replacement for the Marvel Legends figure that I've seen a few people do. I don't know if you've seen that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's a very nice looking shot there. Beautiful angle. It really, really works. And what is that?
That's a Mythic Legions Goblin King.
God, that's superb. And the colored grass just, wow. Very cool indeed. Oh, so many Mythic Legions I would buy if I could. And lots of other... Oh, Gamerverse, we both get ours. What did you think of the figure?
Yeah, he's over there. He's okay.
He's all right, I know. Repaint time. And a bit of Han and Chewie, or Chewie and Luke, I should say. Wow, there we go.
So I'll just for anyone who's interested, I'll probably buy those two SH Figure Arts figures. Being the Stormtrooper disguise man that I am.
Yes. So there's a bunch of other stuff here. Basically, just head to Instagram.com/ToyTribe. Is there anything that you want to highlight in the page? Because there's so much stuff here.
There's just go and check it out. I think
I know. There's so much stuff. Look at this. Oh.
This is the segue. Okay, this is articulated icons with a custom Snake Eyes head. And since the last show or just before the last show, I can't remember, Hasbro and Paramount announced that 2020 G.I. Joe movies were coming back.
Yep.
I think they're rebooting them and everything else.
That's right.
and Cyber Friday, Black Friday, I placed an order.
Nice.
For the articulated icon. And all I can say is 2019 or 2020 better be the 6-inch year for G.I. Joe.
I hope so. I really hope so. Yeah, God, look at that. Such a cool looking figure. Oh. Anyway, Instagram.com/ToyTribe and Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries is where you want to go. That is, I think, pretty much it for the show. I don't think there's anything else we've got, unless you got something.
No, I think it's just kind of...
Time to say Merry Christmas. Happy holidays, Happy Hanukkah, or whatever else we've missed or whatever. Yeah, wow. 2018, 34 episodes. That's not bad. That's not bad. We're busy people, so we squeezed them in wherever we could, but... It's been fun. It's been fun. Thank you to everybody who's watched all 34 episodes. I know there's a few of you. So thank you for doing it and sharing and doing all this stuff. We don't get money for doing this. Yes, we'll get some sponsors, but we love their stuff anyway. So it's not really too much hardship to do that. But yeah, so let us know what you think of the show. Leave a note in the comments below what you think of what we're talking about tonight. Love to hear your thoughts and comments, and that's it for 2018. We'll see you 2019 for the next episode of The 6-Inch Show.
Bye.